super shotgun is nearby. A relic from your past. The priests have kept it hidden from you in this remote location.
Thank you. It is my right to take what is required from that which we created.
Thank you. to see all of these. I'm a fart look last life.
What is up, guys? It is Bucky, and welcome to your 14th intermediate job tutorial. And in this tutorial, we're going to be going over a data structure called a stack. Now, what a stack is it pretty much can be closely related to a stack of dishes. Now, you know whenever you're doing dishes, and you put a new dish on the pile of old dishes, it's always placed on the top of the pile, or the stack. And in Java terms, we refer to this as pushing a dish on the stack. So what pushing means is putting something on top of the stack. And whenever you take a dish off of the stack, what Java calls this is popping a dish off the stack. So you always have pretty much a stack of methods or collection calls or anything you have. And whenever you put something on it, it's called pushing. And whenever you take something off it, it's called popping. So the easiest way to pretty much to learn this is through a demonstration. So that's what I'm going to do. In order to create a stack, just go ahead and we import this in Java Util, but just go ahead and press stack, and then go ahead and we're going to make our data a string because it's the easiest, and you can name it anything you want. I'm going to name mine stack, how creative, and then go ahead and put new stack, and then go ahead and put string in here. Now go ahead and put your empty parameters, because it doesn't take any parameters in this constructor, and then go ahead and the first thing we need to do, we have an empty stack right now, so we need to push something or put something on a stack. So go ahead and put stack, and then we can call methods right from here. So let's go ahead and put push, and as our first item we want to add is a string. I'll just name my bottom. You can name anything you want. So now after this, let's just go ahead and print out the stack after everything we push or pop from it. And this kind of we're going to be building later. So let's go ahead and we'll push three items on this and print it out each time. So just copy this two more times. Third, with three items on it, or three dishes. The first one's named bottom, and that's on the bottom. The second one's named second, and the third one's named third. So now, whenever we pop elements, we don't need to pass it anything. We pretty much don't need to tell it which one it needs to take off, because it automatically always takes the top one off. So instead of passing it in an element, we just name pop and automatically pops off the first element off the top. So go ahead and put stack.pop, and we're going to go ahead and call this three times because we have three items. And what this will do is, what we did here is populate the stack with three items, and then by popping it three times, we removed all three. So now outside your main method, we're going to want to go ahead and build a new method called printStack. So private, and as your parameter, of course, you have to pass it in a stack that is string data, and we'll just name it S for simplicity. And let's go ahead and write a simple if statement. That's the only thing we need to put in here. First, we need to check if the stack is empty. So if S dot and is empty is a built-in method that returns either true or false. It of course returns true if it's empty, and if it's not, it returns false. So that's why we are able to use that. So first of all, check if the stack is empty. If it is, system out print line, and we'll just, and now we can go else. So this else code here is stack, and now we can go else. So this else code is going to run as long as there is anything in our stack. So let's go ahead and put system out print format would probably be the best print for this. And for the format, go ahead and put %s, and this is going to be the stack. And just go ahead and put top and then new line. So whenever we see top, we know that this is the top of the stack. And for your arguments, just pass it s. So you can actually pass an entire stack as a single string variable. So that's a cool thing in this. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. As you can see, the first thing we did is we populated it and printed it out after three times. So we populated it with bottom, bottom, second, and here's the top of the stack. Bottom, second, third, here's the top. And then we popped it three times. We popped third off, we popped second off, and then whenever we popped bottom off, our stack was empty. So that's why we got the code. You have nothing in your stack. So that's pretty much how they use the push and pop and what a stack is. And this is one data structure. It's not the most common, but we're going to be going over some more in the tutorials to come. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'm out of time for this tutorial. but I will see you next time. What is up, guys? It is Bucky, and welcome to, let's see, your 15th intermediate drive tutorial. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be talking about a new data structure, and this is called a priority queue. And what this is it's pretty much closely related to, you know how I related stacks to a pile of dishes? A queue is pretty much as closely related to, like a line at the grocery store or something. Whoever gets there first has the highest priority, and that's who gets taken care of first or checked out. Whoever gets in last, if there's five people ahead of them, they're the least priority. That's who you're going to worry about last. So, unlike a stack where it's the first thing that sits on top, that's what gets taken care of, then it gets popped off. In a queue, the first thing that gets there first, which would be at the bottom, I guess, is the first thing that gets taken care of. So, let's go ahead and view an example of this. And once you do, you'll see what I'm talking about. So, let's go ahead and type priority queue. Type it, and I think I even typed it slow and messed it up. So let's go ahead. It'll tell me if I'm wrong in a second. And go ahead and type pass string data in this, and I'm gonna name mine the letter Q because that's the easiest to do. And just go ahead and copy this again. Q equals set equal to new, paste empty parameters for the constructor. So now we have a queue, and I named it the letter Q because I don't feel like typing anything longer than that. So in order to populate a queue, what you need to do is you need to offer it something. So go ahead and put Q.offer, and what this does is anything you pass it in is going to be the first priority. So the first thing we pass it in is going to be the highest priority. So I'm going to name it first. And let's go ahead and copy this two more times. So, go paste, first, second, and third. So now we have three things in our queue, or which is basically a line. The first thing is the highest priority, the second thing is the second that gets taken care of, and the third thing, this is the last thing that's going to get taken care of when we're doing stuff to it. So in order to print out a queue, just go ahead and put printf, so system out printf. And for this first priority is you need to offer it something. So go ahead and put Q.offer, and what this does is anything you pass it in is going to be the first priority. So the first thing we pass it in is going to be first, second, and third. So now we have three things in our queue, or which is basically a line. The first thing is the highest priority, the second thing is the second that gets taken care of, and the third thing, this is the last thing that's going to get taken care of when we're doing stuff to it. So in order to print out a queue, just go ahead and put printf. So system out printf. And for the format, go ahead and put %s. And for the argument, you can go ahead and put the entire queue. And this is how you print out an entire queue at once. So after this, we're just going to want to print out a blank line. So system out print line. And let's go ahead and make sure we don't have any errors so far. So run this, and now you see our queue is first, second, third. So everything's going good as of now. So now that we know how to put elements in a queue, what you often want to do is something called peek at elements. And this is a way of looking at the element with the highest priority without changing your queue or line at all. So let's go ahead and, in order to do the method peek, put system out printf, and you pretty much want to print out the entire stack again. Let's go ahead and print a string variable, and for your variable it's going to be q, but you want to call the peek method on this. And like I said, this method is going to look at the element with the highest priority, and that's what element it's going to return to you. So let's go ahead and print out a blank line after this. Print line. And now it's going to return to us the element with the highest priority if we did it right, and there we go. So first, it looks at this line right here, the queue, and it returned first. So what that means is this element is the one with the highest priority whenever I'm programming. That's the element or method I'm going to get taken care of first. So aside from peak, another thing you want to do is whenever you're done calling a method or done using a variable, you usually want to remove it. Well, it depends on your program, but you often want to remove it. And in order to remove the element with the highest priority, and you probably want to remove it once you're done using it, you call a method on it called poll. So you call a method called poll on your entire queue, and it automatically searches through it, find what element has the highest priority, and it's going to remove it from your queue. So go ahead and put queue.poll empty parameters, because you don't need to pass it which one you want to remove. It automatically knows what one to remove. So now let's just go ahead and put system out printf, and for the format, go ahead and print out a string variable, and go ahead and might as well just print out our entire queue again. So now that we removed the element with the highest priority, our queue should now only have two elements in it, since it originally had three, but since we removed run, it should have two now. So let's go ahead and run this, and now you see it removed first, so now second and third are the only elements in our queue. So that's the basic of what a queue is and how to use a couple more common methods on it. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. The two from queue. So now that we removed the element with the highest priority, our queue should now only have two elements in it, since it originally had three, but
Snow your jump from the guy. Aynen. Elimden gelen bu kadar. Ha bir de şuna göz atacağım. Ondan sonra sınav. Stack Q. Bir de şuna bakacağım. Cevap. Belki de tam bir sıra gibi bir şey yok, pek benim yok, yapabileceğin çok fazla şey yok. Implement iterable item. Eğer şuna bakarsam hiçbirini kullandım mı? Stack queue veya bag sanırım. Link list diye bir şey kullandım. Aynen. sınavı. Videoyu durduracağım sadece daha rahat hissetmek için.